loved him and believed in him. Trey knew that and had love and respect for him. Thank you, Dighton Coleman. You truly were a role model for Trey. Trey had an incredible ability to remember what he heard and read. He could quote passages from movies, education materials, and conversations. Can you see it? It's okay.
He was definitely blessed with the gift of gab and could sell ice to an Eskimo. He could make you laugh, even when you know you shouldn't. He honored and respected those with disabilities or anyone in distress and was easily agitated when he saw them being mistreated. He was very kind-hearted and would go out of his way to help anyone at any time. That's just one of the things that made him so unique. He made people feel special. People who met him and knew him briefly were impressed by him, and many times a situation would arise that he would run into someone who would relate that to him.
There was this lady one time who went to look at a duplex, and she told Trey she knew him, and he goes, "I'm sorry, I don't recognize you." And she said, "Well, did you used to wait tables at Johnny Carino's in high school?" And she said, "Yes." This is like 7 years later. And she said, "Well, you are a waiter."
He was a MacGyver, like the reference from the movie 6 days and seven nights. He could go into the woods with a Q-tip and a pocket knife and go to shopping mall.
Those are just a few of the things. And for, I've had several people ask me what happened, and Trey got kind of an unusual type of pneumonia. It went into both of his lungs. His left lung collapsed, and he had several tubes trying to drain. And then they found out that from a previous injury or reaction to Bactrim's, he had about half a year before, he got a thing called Stevens-Johnson syndrome. And apparently it caused this massive infection of MRSA. So not only did he have MRSA in his lungs, he had it in his bloodstream. But we pray that God would spare him, but
he was in a good place in his life. He was close to God. He was
thirsty for the word.
Yes, he was amazing, and he was in a good place.
He was in a very good place.
It was his time.
So on May 3rd at 2:30 we removed him from his machine, and he went quietly to meet the Lord. So we're at peace with all of that. Hate that it happened, because I miss him very much. But I want to thank everybody for coming out, and for all the
support.
Kids that were up at the hospital. It was amazing. And thank you all so much, and for putting all this together,
thank you
to honor him. So,
and your words were so kind and sweet, and the prayers really helped. Dilly, your mom, she's like amazing. She liked me what
anyway,
I felt before I got out of bed.
That was just something I wanted to share with you guys, that might have been things that you didn't know about him.
And Saturday at my house, we will have a celebration of life at 2 o'clock. You can come and go. You can come and stay. I don't care. Bring a side dish. Nothing fancy. We're going to have fun. We are going to play games. We're going to do stupid stuff. It's going to be happy. If anybody wants to come early and just hang out, that's fine too. This is going to be a very happy, happy day. No more tears. No tears. So,
those of you who didn't know, Trey got me into Disturbed in about 2001. Some of you will know this as a Simon and Garfunkel song. The song is, it's been a big hit. Trey would love it. I know he was listening to it. Darkness, my old friend, I've come to talk with you again, because a vision softly creeping left its seat while I was sleeping. And the vision that was planted